Welcome back. We are sorry for the for the break in transmission. It's actually the network from my end. Let's hear from the husband. Thank you. Yes, sir. Don't be safe from me. Sorry for the
okay, like I was saying. What like I said, I don't know that she will bring this matter here. If I know, I don't know. I'm surprised. If you would have brought this matter here, I don't even know the reason why you brought this matter here, because it shows that you are tired and you are helpless about these children. Because you think you can do it all alone. And me, myself, honestly, after I brought this matter here, but I thought that is. Because what I heard in the street, they are one-sided, George or whatever. So it didn't give me impress to come. Because my children, thank God she mentioned where my children are schooling. Before they left here, I was paying through my nose. And that's the much I love my children. But when it comes to Lady, because she has very advantage over these children than me, on this issue on ground. She has a very big advantage. That's why I will not go after and start dragging the children with her and all that. I can't do that because I know my rights. So that's the reason why I was like, I'm surprised. So when I heard this report, I was actually happy, sort of. So even though however the judgment might go, it is God's will and God is involved in this matter. So I'm not afraid. I'm here to testify the truth of whatever that conspires. Yeah, so I need to start from the beginning of what happened between me and her. From the beginning of the marriage, because this started with the beginning of this marriage. When the father called me to take one of his junior brother, because she was the senior. So I agreed, because I normally came to Lagos, about to buy market. I stayed in Lagos. So I agreed. So when I traveled down to Aba, I have a decision within myself that because I don't want anybody, because it's just early marriage. We just got married, wedded. Everything happens in yes, 2 months. I'm not lying, yes. Everything happens in 2 months. Because of what? We think that we are worshiping in the same place. That is the point. We think that we are worshiping in the same place. And my mother, when I'm trying to make investigation concerning, my mother told me that she don't really have issue with her. But the only thing that she have issue with her is that she don't greet people. But she has serious issue with the father. But the mother is that, her issue with the mother is that the mother don't really talk to the husband whenever he goes from, probably is afraid of him or whatever, I don't know. Even they always, that the mother cannot even talk because the father always treats her somehow, even in the presence of the people in the fellowship. So, and I said, with the little of my knowledge then, I said, I don't have issue with the parents. So if it is something I know now, I will not go either. I said, I will not have issue with the parents. That I will know how to handle it because I'm not living with the parents. That is the person I'm living with. Unless that I can handle any issue that comes from the parents. Unless the young lady conspires with the parents. That is when I will have issue. But as for, I will know how to handle it. So that is what I told my mother. I said, unless if the young girl is dancing on the tune of the parents, that is when I'll have issue and problem with her. And that is exactly what happened, because I don't know that so many things was hiding behind me for a certain time so that if I have a male child, they'll misbehave. Because immediately I have that male child. My life, my house, everything turned upside down. The character, everything changed. But that is not my problem. So when I told, when the father told me, he said, okay, we are just newly married. I don't think if it is up to, let me not lie. We just got married. I don't want to place in a month or a year because it's not just far. Within that year, we got married on November 14 or so, yes, or 29, if I'm not mistaken. 2014. That was 2014. So when I, when the father told me, I now said, okay, I now travel down to the Aba, because I normally come to buy goods to sell in Lagos. So I now came, I have a change of mind, because what I had before I even thinking of getting married, that I don't need to any of my wife's side or my own side to stay with me when I when I'm newly married, so that I will focus and we'll learn each other. So and I said, I have a change of mind. I called the father and said, it will not work again, please. And I'm sorry. So he said, no, that he's coming over. This is not something we talk about before. That he will come with the wife. He just says true. From about, they live very close. They came to our place. And any issue. So, and they now asked me, say, why did I change my mind? I said, nothing. I want to have a privacy for now. That is, I don't think it's wise for me to bring anybody now. That is not really wise. So he was trying to know the reason why. I said, I don't have any other reason. That this is what happened, but because he said he want to, the boy want to come over and be doing a start lesson so I will enter school. I said, okay, I don't have any problem with that. Only God knows that, okay, since it's like this, let him start lesson here. I'll be funding his lesson. Even when he enters school, I will sponsor him in school. Not even I will pay. So they were not happy. So they were like putting some questions to me as if the boy must live with me. So later when they were leaving, I was seeing them off. It struck my mind, just, but I believe that only the truth can set me free, and it has been setting me free from the onset of this situation. I told him, must your son live with me? I give you this opportunity. There's no nothing like it. Your mood, everything changed. He didn't say anything. He said, okay, that he's sorry. If he didn't say thank you, that he's sorry. And now came back to Lagos. She did not ask me anything till tomorrow. Why? This is the person that I told her when I was leaving that I'm going to bring her brother and her father. After a word, said anything that is as in.
It's actually the service. Yes, sir.
So, I came back when we had the wedding. My mother was with us for some time because she's not feeling well. So when we had the wedding in Lagos, we asked her to stay so we can give her a proper treatment. So she was staying with us. One day I came back. My mother called me and told me that it's 6 o'clock because normally to stay with his wife. I said, what can is somehow, why can you do such thing? So initially, even before then, I've been having some, because I told her that I don't want our matter to cross this, my roof or my door. I don't want any matter to cross, any issue that came out, let's sort it out once and for all. We don't need to take, we are an adult, like, we don't need to take any issue out. We can iron it even without getting to our parents. But some one or two things have been happening. So that day, I got angry. I took my phone and called the father. I said, see what your daughter did. What the father told me is that that I should train her now, that he has trained the one that he had did the one that he can do, that I should continue where he stopped. I tried to call the father. She would do as if she restrained from what she's doing or her reaction. So, but my problem is that her father is not taking a proper rule or what he's supposed to do, even to call the daughter in order. So that one, and now we are living, because we just married earlier. So when even that period, yes, she don't used to wash my undies. She don't used to wash anything about my clothes. I'm not disputing that. I'm not holding it as an offense to her at all. I have a boys that stay with me. They are learning trade with me. They watch it. You are forcing yourself. You know the person will complain. So I'm forcing myself because you have to do this. But your complaint is affecting me. But I'm trying to force myself as a man. That is the situation I was in. Not that she will not do it, but she will come and lament over it. As in, people that are supposed to do it, and they will, even in my shop, I will not see my boys and send that, because I have other shops, second shop. I will not see my boys and send that to go and get fabric for a customer. But she will complain that people that are supposed to do it are here, and I'm sending her. All these things I was like. So that period, when she put to bed, her mother came. Before her mother came, and her mother brought her little brother, his blessed memory, Oloma. He was little, maybe 9 or 10, I can't remember. So, together with her, when we are staying together, I told her, see you, Shebi, I tell you. She said, let him come, and when the mother will be going, that they will go together. I said, I don't have a problem with that, but anything my mind is against, I don't want it to bring issue between us. I know the reason why I am saying it. She said, no problem. So something happened when the mother was at was in Omugo. A faint or a slight misunderstanding. It's not a serious issue at all. So I left to the market. When I was leaving, no, I left the market. So the following day, when I came back, when I wanted to leave, I now asked her to prepare a fast food for me. They were laughing at me, she and her mother, that I would have acted the way I did before. That was the motive. But me myself, I'm not like other men that I'll give my wife money for food and I'll come back, I'll reject the food. It's a stupid, I'm sorry to use the word, it's my end money, no. So I catch up the joke and now left, just laugh, because it's obvious, as in what happened that morning, it's obvious, we just laugh, I left. So after then, my mother stayed, because we took her to Jolad Hospital, because she was really down, even when we had our tradition. She didn't even stood up from the chair that day. She was just there. She couldn't do anything. So because we have a wedding in 1 month interval, So we have to, when she came for the a wedding, so we decided to take her to hospital. I was trying to do that from July. They refer us to other tests to run as a physician and all that. So when my mother was with us, she did something that, because I want to point all these areas. I want to point all these areas. Now, she was told to have a reconciliation with my mother. She came back. I told her, because my mother was in the fellowship. I called my mother. What approach did she give you? She said that I should, you know, mothers. I know my mother. She's not a troubled son. My late mother, anyway. Sorry. She's not a troubled son. She was the other referred me to her. She said, Francis, my son, don't worry. I should leave. I said, no. She said she came to meet her, but she did not, the impression that she gave her wasn't good. I said, no, that she's coming back. Because peace matters. Joy. When we are smiling outside and your heart is bitter, progress is not guaranteed. I said, Mama, no, she needs to come back.
Sorry to cut you. You've not stated what she did that caused the problem between her and your mom. What happened?
Her and my mother.
Yes. That you were telling her to go and beg your mom to go and reconcile with your mom.
It was a message that was given to her. It's a message that was given to her in the church. So, because the reason why I didn't want to, I don't know if people are about something or whatever. So that's why I was keeping it. So it's a message to her. So I said that she's coming back again. So when she came back, she had it and came back. I said, okay. Even with my senior brother, he was talking about, there's no concern that she has come twice and I send her back again, she came, that there's no problem. I said, but the impression, I was not getting it right. And she was complaining, even before my mother, doesn't allow her to wash it in my own house. And I'll ask her, because she normally visits her mother, her family, when she was staying with my mother before she came down to Lagos. And I asked her, do you tell your mother that your mother will know what to tell you? That is the reason why I asked you. Do you tell your mother that my mother does not allow you to watch? She said no. Those ones I wasn't an issue, because like I said, I want to start from the beginning. It wasn't an issue anywhere. But when my mother left, okay, my mother had left before she gave birth, and the mother came. So when the mother came, and after the omugwo, she came and met me and said, please, let my little brother stay. Let our little brother stay and be helping her. The boy has been giving me a headache. Later, we are living at my 12th, Aglite State. When they had a fight with Hausa and the Igbo, I'm sorry, Hausa and the Yoruba in my 12th, in that estate, we have to leave that place and stay in our ministry. That is where we are, because I almost got victim that very Thursday. So when we are staying in our ministry, our load idea, so we are looking for a house elsewhere. So one day I left to the work, to the market. I came back. There's no food. She now announced that anything in there. She said no. She was nagging, angry. We are in a one room that they gave to us with one other lady. She was nagging. I said, okay, let me give you money so that anything that we can, even though it's tea or Okay, I didn't mention anything. I said anything that you can get, we'll eat this night. That there's no problem. It's no one fault now. So she was like, she was so aggressive that I supposed to drop money now. I know what I supposed to. I said, but I didn't remember. It shouldn't be an issue. And you that's supposed to tell me that, know that there's no, you saw me when I was leaving. Of course, we are together here and I left. She was like, no, that day I don't understand. Because I begin to understand that this marriage is just it's for a mission. That is where I'm ending the whole thing. It's for a mission. So when she was like, no, I should say what we eat. Because with all the arguments, I already get upset. I said, this shouldn't be an issue. I came back and there's no food. I didn't remember to draw food. You that's supposed to ask me money for the food, you didn't ask me. Okay, nobody is blaming you. You are blaming me, and I'm blaming. Then let's forget about that. Go and get something. She said, I must say what we eat. That I must say what we eat. I was like, even my daughter, when I wanted to touch that my daughter, I want to carry her. She went and grabbed the little baby, and the lady was there and said, ah, is he not his father? Leave. Why are you dragging the child with me? Yeah, I was surprised because we are in the church. I don't want to make any noise. But what makes her to be flinging up, I don't know. So she stood up. I said, if you don't want to make anything and I'm not ready, I said there that I'm not going to utter any lie. Whatever that comes out, God will bear my witness. I said, and I stood up to leave the place. Said, I'm not ready to tell you, to suggest to you whatever, because it's becoming an argument which is not supposed to. I'm not telling you what you should make. I am leaving. She blocked me and held me on my shirt. I was telling her to leave me. She was hitting me on my neck, on my chest. I tell her to leave me. And the lady was like, ah, has he got into that? I didn't say anything. Because me, I wouldn't want to get myself embarrassed in that place. Later, she left me because I'm not sleeping with her. But as she's sleeping with another lady. So we have a room boys. So I went there to sleep. Later, we relocate at Abeokuta Street. So we are there. One day, so many things. One day I came back. I traveled, I came back. I came back in the afternoon and I said, let me just stay with her and have my rest too, instead of going to market. And I'll stay. So she started, because what she normally does is, me, I clean things, I clean my house. Is this recently? In fact, this recently that she left, that my boy sometimes, because the whole issue was adding problem to me over these years. So I don't struggle most times. So is this recently, I will send my boys to go and sweep my room and mop it. I don't. I will do it myself. It's not that I'm holding it up, because I would like to do it, because I do my own things the way I want, because I would like to do it wholeheartedly. The way I want. So that day, and what she does, anytime she has that, if I'm coming back like today, either she will clean the toilet or sweep or mop the house for me to come back. Either that day or the following. So that day I came back, she started cleaning the house. Remember, I said I'm not ready to lie against anybody. She started doing it and I joined her. So when we are mopping and cleaning, my bed frame, yeah, because I will clean, I will use Omo and sponge, because it's white, to scrub it, and the mirror standing. So the detergent was much, the one that I was using. She was like, that I put too much detergent. said, okay, I didn't know when I apply it much, that I will still use water too. So she was, oh my goodness, she was like, hey, why did I put it too much? It's too much. I said, I will clean it now. You still use water to clean it. That, did I offend, did I commit any crime that I came and I decided to, I said I want to come and rest. Normally, when I'm single, I'll just go. Even sometimes, if I come early, I will head to the market because all these boys this time around, you can't predict them. So I said, have I done anything wrong? Why would it be an issue? So, you know, an issue, a husband and wife, matter, you wanted to link to another thing. The thing was linking and linking. Ah, at a point, I get upset. I said, why would this be a problem? The thing lingered till the following morning. And it was raising more dust. To the point that I'm leaving to the market. She locked the door and hold the key. I said, give me, open door now, let me leave. Let me go to the work. I said, no, I'm not going anywhere. That I'm not going anywhere. That any time that I will have a small quarrel, I will try to either I leave the room or I will leave the sitting room if the quarrel. I said, because I don't understand you. You will talk to talk, something that is not supposed to bring an issue. It will become a problem. Now, you will not allow me. She locked the door and held the key. I don't want to struggle the key with her because I actually need to know what she wants to do. I think before then, before that one, she held me. I was telling me to beat her. I said, are you normal? Some people are out there trying to complain to people that their husband is beating them. And you are holding me, telling me to beat you, that I should beat you. If I want, that I should beat you. So that thing, I said, I don't want all your wallet. I didn't touch her. What I did, I broke the key. I spoiled the key. And I went to the market. I called the carpenter man to come and fix that same day to come and fix the key. I called the father. I told the father, see, this is what your daughter did. But I don't understand what is happening. So when later, because I was trying to ask her, why do you act like this? What happened when we reconciled? Because I was confused. She was like, what she did say that time, I don't really get it. But she find one thing, she didn't want to tell me, but she find one thing that is not relevant, that is not from nowhere, and told me, and it's okay. When I asked her, what did your father tell you I told them that you locked me? She said, the father said that she shit in the church. I said, that's all. She said, yes. I said, okay. Now, later on, the brother was living with us, and the brother was giving me a headache. I will tell you, which she knew about it. Where the brother is schooling is where my daughter is schooling. That is brother. It's the same school, because I said, if we want any investigation, I don't mind. Because the person that owned the school is one of our leader in the, it's long ago, she was given a time. It's very long. So the lady that was in the school, that the man is what the wife that owned the school. So, and I'll ask, and I'll to the boy, he will not wash the plate before leaving to the school. Sometimes he will leave very late. I said, what are you doing? So, and having serious issue with the boy. One day I came back, she told me that she flogged the boy. She flogged head out of him. So the only thing I told the boy, that I'm warning you. Even at a point, I give him suspension for 1 week. You're not going anywhere from this house. If you continue disobeying me and repeating my not to keep my instruction, which I did, And it did not stop it. It continues. So later, my late senior sister, the son, that was the first son, because I was the one that carried the boy when I was living with my sister in Aba. So he actually came for a holiday. So he was with us, because he has finished his school, secondary school, yes. So she not move around. Okay. So he now came with us and stayed with us. And the reason why I even accepted, because the boy is already there. I have accepted from the beginning. So he was staying with us. And to be honest, I was having the heat, because I told the boy, anything that happens, don't call your mother. Tell me. So boy, he rather, when I was traveling to the east, my wife, Favour called me and told me that they went to the fridge and the freezer and took something, ice block or whatever, that she used it to preserve the food that she kept there. And she has given them instruction. I said, okay, it's true. How many people were there when you give them that instruction? And who went to that fridge? She mentioned the two people that was not in the house, then I've not came to my house when the session was given. I said, okay, no problem. When I came back, there's no problem. But tell them that nobody should come to go there again, since it's the people that you haven't told them before. So I now came back. I didn't know that boy had already called his mother. It's not that the mother called me and was like, so the mother, the I don't know that the mother, the boy have already told the mother. So when I found out, I told the boy, I said, I told you, anything that happens here, let me know. I will handle it. Don't tell your mother. Your mother is my sister. And the one that carried you. I don't want anything that will bring issue here. I know what I'm saying. And the boy was calling her sister. And she was like, don't call me sister. I'm not your sister. You should call me auntie. When I heard it clearly, when the boy knocked and opened my door and called her sister, and she met utter that word, that he should not call him sister, that he's not his sister, that he should call him auntie, that he's not his sister. That word, that you don't want to ease yourself, that you do, I don't know. So at a point, the whole thing, that boy and his brother was giving me an issue. I'm telling you, if anytime I want to come down to the house, I will feel like, and I said, one day, send them home. I brought the boy, though I already called the parents that I'm bringing them. I called the parents that I'm bringing their child. When I traveled down to the Aba with the boy, when I came there, bring his son back. I said, what did your daughter told you one day that he called you, complaining to you about this, your son? Most especially in this human rights table, that I need to clear my mind. But if that is the case, there's no problem. So when the mother was like, I must tell her. I said, no. If you tell me what your daughter told you concerning her, in fact, that should be the reason why. So before I now left, the man called me and was like, he was not in the house. I just brought his son and just dumped him. I should have waited for him. I said, what is the difference between you and your wife? I came all the way from Lagos. I came down and brought I even brought him. I didn't put him to the motor to come. So these are so many things. So and now that one. But things I want to just to break it out, just like you said. We move to another place. where I'm living now. I think so, yes. She took no tablet. She now said, she was even complaining there in the right in this slot that she don't, I said, if you don't like it now, you know, it's not a full complaint. She was like, let me manage. I said, don't manage it. Better leave it now if you don't want. She said, let me manage. I said, these people are, they are my people. I've been buying phone that I'm giving people. I want to give people. These are the people where I'm buying food. Say now, until that phone, you know, I didn't know how many months it lasts. You know, something you use when you don't like. So that is how that phone spoiled. And she was like, I said, okay, hold on. I was using Joni. And the reason why I bought that Joni is the battery, because of the nature of my business. The battery has a long span time. So when we went to the place, it just nearby to my marketplace, Stadio Ocean. So we are choosing a phone. And that's my own. They always face their new thing out every year. And that man is Nova 9. That one. No, not Nova 9, something, not Nova 9. So, when she says she want that my own, and that my own has faced out, the one that is around is the current one for that year, and is expensive. That time was like 100 and something thousand. But when I got my own, is 91,000 or so. So, the one that is senior to that one is 100 and something. I said, I don't have this money now, but you know, if I have, I will pay, but for now. Because I was even forced myself to be able to get that phone because you don't have phone using at that moment. She now said, okay. Even those people there, at a point, they got upset. Those ladies that were staying there. I said, okay, take this Samsung. She said, no. Take this one. She said, no. That is this my own. I said, you know the reason why I was using this phone? Yeah, I don't know even how to. One is more than WhatsApp and calls. I don't even go to Instagram and all that. That is the reason why I'm is the battery. She said no. And she was nagging. Eventually, we got one app this your own. Since if anybody calls me, even though my customer calls me, that you can, since we are together, that I can still, and I will put my SIM card here on my own. So there's no problem. She said no, I know that I should have my own. It was an issue again. From that day to the next day, I was like, what is your problem? Why this thing be an issue? That I told you, okay, can you have my own? Why? That day, in the morning, like that, she was so aggressive, nagging, this, that. I said, I can't continue with this. What is it? I should leave my house. But I'm not interested again. She was coming closer to me because that's something she always does. She always likes to trigger my anger for me to react over her. So she was coming closer to me in order to beg me. I said, I don't understand. You should leave my house. What is the problem? Did I do anything wrong to you? So I when she was coming closer, I heard my back. I said, stay back. Don't conclude. When she came, I was using the belt on her hand. So I didn't know she snapped it and saved it on her phone. So after, so when I went to the school to pick my two keys back from this, I said, you should leave my house. That you should leave my son, that I'm no more interested. I don't know what is happening. She was like, so we have to call. She was calling some people. So I called our leader in our ministry. He came, and she was saying, "The what conspires this one now is that when she has the last baby, the pregnancy, she because the pregnancy is actually more than 9 months." But we are praying and all that, asking for grace of God. And she had to stay in the ministry. So she now said, and I'm staying with her and be shutting, but I cannot do it full time with her condition. I said, let me call your parents to come, your mother. She said, okay. I was like, because I know what I went through. The first one, the father was like asking me some questions. I'm carrying her wife. This, that, him, the kind of that, so, something that I need to beg before your wife to come and do a mugo to you, to her daughter. Something like that. So I now call the father. The father said that the mother is doing something. He need to round up some one or two things. That she will come in 2 weeks' time. I said, okay. And there's no problem. She later came. As she later came and stayed with her in the church. So later, she now called me and told me that that his brother will come to assist her too. To assist her that her mother cannot do the whole thing. That her own immediate senior, I mean junior brother, the one she's senior direct. I was like, okay. When the boy came, they were all staying in the church. Because my own is that nobody, I had experience, nobody is coming to my house. So when the boy came, he was staying there. And now, when she put to bed, the boy was still staying in the church. And the mother, so 4 days, because she has years. And I know the promise, this that she was saying that I didn't take her to hospital, that I said, she knew. My first child, I promised God, I sacrificed one cow to God. If God, please, I want her to put birth good in safe. It's the second one that I did not have that much. She did not really have much issue. But you see, the first one and the third one, she has issue with them. Then the third one, I still promise God that I will give you one cow. Please, let my wife put the birth in safe and sound. Which she had, she told me what she went through on the theater, which she later had the boy. And I said, thank God that is life. Who know what could have happened? So after then, when she came back to the house with the mother, we are all together. I was receiving a call. And before then, the father called me. I have a project in the East. Because over how many years, I haven't been in the East. It is a family issue. But I haven't been in the East because of family issue. So I'm trying to build a house. Even with me and my brothers, all my siblings, to stay for now. By God's grace, they will be building their own. So I have that project, and the father with one of our elder in the East, he called the father. He said that the father must be there as one of the elder in the foundation. I said I wanted to take everybody by surprise, even my own people, that it got a point, I'll make it known to them. I want to make it as a surprise. He said no, that this one is more than a surprise. And they will not, it will not happen that way. I said, I don't want to bring it. He said, I must call the father. So the man called the father. The father was there when they did the foundation and all that. So now when the father called me that I should help him and give him 1.5 million. That he want to add with the one he has and send his brother to abroad, yes, my father, and send his son, the one that is with me. I didn't even know. It's late, I from head to head that I knew that the boy came for his travel, that he want to travel. But he was working in the fast food then. So I said, okay, what matter can bring, talk can bring, and I'll tell her that I really want to send one of your brother to abroad, by God's grace. But I don't want to tell. I don't even want to tell you. But I don't. I want to keep it for myself. My brother, immediate brother, he just my mother. My mother was a second wife from the house, so we have never been to the village we stayed in Aba because we have a small house in Aba. My father built. So said, so I need to build up, use him to for as an agent. I said, I don't have this money now. I don't have the money now. Why will I be calling the man again? He said, I should call him now. Because I don't know what makes the man so angry. So we ended the call. I was receiving a call from a lady. She know her. And banging, shouting, you know, calling Amaka, Amaka. Me, I thought that is the Amaka that I know in Lagos here, that I know. She was calling her. I said, who is this? What is it? That day, she did not tell me anything. We are sitting in the bed. She was there. Maybe she knew that the lady would come here. I don't know. So I was receiving the call. She said, I should put this speak out. I said, why will I put this speak out? That I was asking you since 2 days now. What is the problem that you don't want to tell me? Why will I now put my phone speak out? Has it gotten to that? She said, I must put it speak out. I said, no, I can't. So when she, because she always do it by force most time. When she came to, want to grab the phone, and I left the house and went downstairs and answered the call. Nothing concerns me on the call. The lady was complaining the issue he has with the father, with the parents, and the brothers, where we are, they are worshipping. So I said, this thing that you are saying, it does not really, I don't know where to, I can't put mouth. Rather, the person you have this issue is an elder. So look, go and meet Elder Onukebe. She knew who I'm talking about, his father knew. Go and meet him. Meet one of them. Go and discuss. That I can't put matter to what I don't know. I can't know where. I don't know where he started at. So, but all I'm pleading to you, she was like telling me that my wife did, what she did, that, you know, that she was talking to her anyhow, that I got phone for her. But it's not hidden something. So that I got what she was. Ah. So I now came upstairs. She was ranting that why somebody that has CS, the way she banged on the door, that one day if I come, that she will carry the children and leave. The mother was there. So I want to find out the reason why she don't want to tell me because one day I was receiving a call. I put it speak out. For with that Amaka, because I was looking for Omoshe, all this boy that will stay with, and she promised me that she will help me to get two. So when I was having that conversation with her, though the lady told me in the ministry concerning the father that she don't like the way the man they always have a little crush. Me, I don't listen to her because it doesn't concern me. So when she was telling me. A woman doesn't go for talk for a human being in their own town, as in to go and discuss about to bring Omoshe or boy to. I should look for a man that will go. So we are trying to mention. I thought she was mentioning her father. So I now cut. I now put the phone, remove it on silent, because I thought I don't want her to now say something that will seem as if we are gossiping over there. Because she don't believe it, but that is, I said, I will say the truth. I don't care what comes out, but God will bear my witness. So that is the reason why I remove it from there, so that I don't want the lady to now say, I don't want to call his father, this, so he's not rapporting together. So I didn't even know, eventually, what the person that she was even suggesting for me was the Onukebe, the other man. When I ended the call, I almost fell on my knees to beg her, because she thought the negative part of it, that we are gossiping over her father. I begged her that morning. I begged her with eyes in, only God knows, because in my heart, I was like, ah. So I was now thinking, so this is the reason why I was asking you what happened. You didn't tell me this same Amaka. And you think that we are gossiping and conspiring against you. Ah, we are getting it wrong. Okay. What of the time that we are living at Abeokuta, that it has happened like twice. I came back from market. You are receiving a call. Immediately, I opened door. You called the call. I said, what about that one? And if I ask her, she will say she's discussing with her mother. I said, why do you end the call? That she's paying respect to me. I said, what kind of respect is that? That you are discussing with your mother? What kind of respect? What? I don't understand. I said, what about that one? Did I react? Why do you now keep on reacting over this issue? That it has gotten to this point. So, and now, I that day, she banked and I left, keep silent, and they took the child on the children's room. She took the child in the children's room, and they were sleeping there. I keep silent. I didn't want to talk anything. It happened like two, three days, right? Because they told me the dream. I'm the one that had the dream, sorry. So I said, this is what the dream I had. And if not one thing, I would have just kept silent. That you were here, you didn't say anything. She said that she was in the room, that she didn't hear what her daughter was saying. I said, you, she ask your daughter, though I don't eat night food, at a point, I stopped eating night food because I don't like the way it grows my tummy. I don't eat night food. But when we came back, if we always came back, sometimes we came back early. And the mother did not say anything, no, when I complained about that food stuff. And I told her about the issue of my sister. She said, I said, two of you are adults. The reason why I raise it is for you to just sort yourself out. I'm not putting mouth in your matter. That is what I told her. So I now got what I give. The mother and the father. I gave the father. The father did not call me till tomorrow. I bought almost senator, almost six. I got for myself, and I put money in an envelope. The father did not call me till tomorrow. I was like, is it because of the 1.5 million you asked me for? It was that, you know, it was even like during that week that the mother, the mother want to go back to East. Yeah, I skipped that one. Yes. So, and now she now told me that please let her brother come to the East. I mean, to stay with us. Okay. You know what happened? Let me cut it short then. Then the brother eventually came, which I don't want to. And I saw the brother wearing my clothes. I said, who gave you my clothes? He said, he's long wearing it. I said, who gave you my... She said, she's the one. She even gave one of my boys, and she get another one for me. I don't even know the one she get for me to replace it. I didn't say anything. So the boy was staying with in the children's room where our house girl was staying. The girl is of age. But because of, if I say now, it would be as if she nags so much, to be honest. So I keep silent. But one day, I saw him coming out from the sitting visitor's room, toilet. I was like, what are you doing? Including her. She disrespectful to me to the core. To be honest, she is. So the boy told me that it's long, they have been using it. I said, okay. I don't want to see you there again. And in this announcement, when I meet her in the room, I said, do you aware that this boy is using? He said, since my boys are not washing that visitor's toilet, since our brother came, he has been washing it. So I said, what do you say? I said, what do you say? Ah, that even sometimes she have slapped one or two of them, in occasion, which I tell them, don't do. And there's no time you will tell me. In fact, you can't tell them to do something that they will not. Today, I rang my bell in the house to pray once it's 10 o'clock. I rang the bell to pray. I rang the bell. I went inside my sitting room toilet to ease myself. When I came out, I didn't know that his brother have told someone of my boy to pray. So when we finished short praises, I was about to ask someone to pray. And that one want to start praying. I said, who asked? These are the things that makes me to give the boy what to do in the house, which he did not do. Because one day, when we are doing interstate, it's my boys that wash my clothes. So when we are doing a day off, and now we came out that day, I didn't remember to give them clothes
Sir
to wash.
Francis, what I'm asking is, the reason why you took her to the village, is this why you are saying all those
She
stories?
Took herself to the village. That is why I want to bring this story down, so that we all will understand that if I jump and say that she took herself to the village, we all will understand. I'm sorry for taking time.
So just have to... Others are waiting for me. Others are...
Try it next time. I will leave this room for you. The other day, I taught you for says you face the wall. Reason, I don't know. Maybe because of your brother, what's conspired between you, I don't know. You face the wall. Please, stay like that. So, she now stood up and said, she's on her own and is running now. And I should not talk about sex. I'm talking about sex. I said, I don't need your wallow. Please. She was like trying to drag me and... I said, no, leave me. I don't want you. You always want to create sin. So when I saw it on her, I now stood up to leave the room. She held me. I now pushed her. She fell. I now stood up again and dragged me and was pushing me to the wardrobe and dragged me for a long time. She was dragging me for a long time. I said, okay, leave me. Leave me. She was dragging me for a long time. She really wanted to trigger my anger. And I was telling her, leave.
So, because of the dragging.
So, when I pushed her, she fell. When I'm trying to leave the room, she come and held me. I pushed her, she fell. She stood up again and held me. I was dragging me to the wardrobe. Was pushing me. I said, leave me now. That I know that you want to create a scene. Because she knew, I'm not a woman beater. So... She was dragging me. She was dragging me to the point. I said, leave me. Leave me. She said, what she was saying that, why is it that every time we have issue, I would like to leave the room. I said, because you don't want to settle any matter. Will I be here and be whining out? If I talk one, they don't finish talking. So why will I be here? Will you trigger my anger? Why will I be sitting here with you and be talking? She was pushing me. And so when I hit her, one, two, she held my manhood. And dragged me. I shouted. She did not leave me. I now bite her on her shoulder. She now left me. I held me. I sat on the bed. She was still holding me. There's nothing on this earth she did not talk. That when she wants to leave my house, that she's not married again, that I insisted that she... What she's saying, I don't really understand. But because I don't want to answer her. Later, when the second time she heard my manhood, when she came to the sitting, because I don't normally stay in that living room. I mean, a room. I don't normally stay there. Sometimes I stay in the parlor to watch TV. So in the midnight, I'll enter the room and sleep. So she came that day and was begging me. I was telling me, begging me that she's sorry. I said, don't worry, that I've already called my elders, our people, for a meeting. In the respective of what I'm seeing in my house, that I don't really understand again. She said I've said what I said, and I'm taking my decision that we'll travel to the east. So when she was trying blocking my view to the television, I was like, is it how you beg? Leave my view now. If you want to beg, you sit one side and be begging. Is it a crime? Is it how somebody beg? She said, anyhow she likes, she will bear. She was like, even, she was talking nonsense. It's not even, because this is why I put it back in, because I said I don't want to place any lie. but she was calling it a beg. She was saying a lot of things that I don't really understand. There's something she said that she even when my brother's sister was that she don't talk to her anyhow. I was like, that means I insulted your brother. I didn't even say anything because all those things that she was saying, I don't want to answer her to God who made me. I don't want to answer her at all. I don't want to create anything again because that is what she always wants. She always like violent. And now, at a point, it was after 1 to 2, I now picked my kid to go down and to look for any place, either hotel or a chapel to go and stay. She came and blocked me and held me and dragged me back. I've gotten to the door of our staircase. She dragged me back to the sitting room and was heading me from the back. I said, okay, leave me. Leave me. I'm not going anywhere again. Leave me. She was holding me. I said, you want to create a scene again like the one you did the other day? She was holding me to a point. I don't want to fling her on the wall. She was holding me so tight and was dragging me like a kid. You can't, countless millions of men you can treat like that. I thought what I would do. I didn't. Immediately, I over my head to help her hair like this. She held my man do that again. And I left her. She now left me. She now leave me. I said, you have done your worst. Now, this is what you want. Before she now went inside. So, and I called the father. I said, the father, we are coming. My people are coming to see your people. He said, there's nothing like that. That I should tell him what is the problem. That he can sort it out. I said, you cannot. Previously, many times that something like this happened, I can't even see the way you handle itself. Not talk of, but this one is above me. That we need to come. He said that there's nothing that there's over his dead body. Okay, it's my brother that he used that word. So, I now end the call. Okay, what I told him that after interstate, in some months' time, because they announced when they will do interstate traveling, I will tell you the date that we are coming. We'll now end the call. So, before a month, I think it's not up to a month, and I called him again and told him, this is the date we are coming up. He now told me that, he have told me that I should tell him the issue, that he can handle it. I said, are you for real? Since I sent you, I called you for close to a month. You haven't even called me back to ask me, what is the problem? Or in-law, calm down. What is the problem? I know that time you are boiling. This is close to a month. You didn't call me. And you are telling me you can handle it. It is not possible. I can't believe you. Even previous one, I don't see the way you handle it. In fact, that is even beyond my... That is when he called my brother. My brother told me that our elders are... We involve our brother, my elder sisters and everybody. That is beyond me now. And it's beyond him. He told my brother over his dead body that he will allow such meeting. I said that meeting must hold. So... That very day, we enter motor with my children. We drive down to the east. We lodge in the hotel in Ihala. The following day, we went down to their place. My people came from Aba, from the east, to join us with the man that stands as a father, because my father is late. The man that stands as a father for me, he came down with us. So, and I told the man that stand as the father, if his father did not bring the witness and the brothers, the son of his brother, one of his brother, his son, the elder, one of his brother, elder son, if he did not bring him, that there's nothing we can say in there. Those people need to be there. So he said that he have told him that. Yeah, I said, tell him, oh, and I have already told him. The man eventually told me that he agreed to bring them. Because he was telling me, I should tell him what is the matter. What will you tell the? I said, we are coming in the respect of it. Why will I be discussing the meeting that we're supposed to head? Is it the way this is being done? We are just coming for the respective of your daughter. And you want me to be telling you what happened? It's not done like that. That when we came, we discussed issue. And that is what I came for. God who made me. That is what we came for. So on getting there, the following day, we lodged in the hotel. The following day, we drove to their house. We didn't see, the witness. He called somebody. I saw two people or three people that I did not know them. I don't know them. Even on the traditional day, I've never seen them before. And his father's sister that was there. So, and I asked him, where is the witness? Say the witness, this is the witness. Because I snapped it from my album. And he looked at it and showed it to my brother. I said, this is not the witness. But I know him. He's on my phone. So he said, he's his brother, his junior brother. There and then, we call the brother, the junior brother of the man that he claimed that is the witness. We put his speak out. The young man said that he did not know what we are talking about. In the speak out, I said, what of your brother's son? He said, that one is in Iyo, that he's on his way coming. Since we didn't tell him when the time that we are coming. I said, are you for real? Me that came from Lagos and lodged in the east there and lodged the following day, we start coming. And your brother that is coming from this thing, he now say he's on his way coming. I said, I can't believe you now because you already told me that I didn't tell you the time. Your daughter was calling you, contacting you, even when we left this Lagos. So when we are saying that, and my sister, that is when my sister, because she works in the local government, she was in the department of human rights or whatever. She said the cases, all these, most times, she threw it as a suggestion that it's not the cases like this doesn't end one day. Sometimes it end. He didn't tell them that we are coming next day or any time. That is what she said when they were saying, this matter, are you sure say you go end today? That is what makes her to utter that word. So when I was telling the father, I told her, I said, when I left the village, she sent me a message that I should send her money for food. As in, when it's 2 days, I'm not lying, 2 days.